John had written a song, and it was kind of on the back burner as far as songs that we were going to do. But when we were cutting drums with Nick,
hey, whoa.
Everybody went on a lunch break, and I sat there with the session of this song, and I kind of, I don't know, just grabbed parts that moved me.
This song originally, I kind of pulled together actually to submit to Kansas a few years back when they were doing their first album, then they decided they weren't going to use outside writers. So I think a lot of people submitted songs. It's a very different version than this one, you know, so I took some of that section and put a whole new song around it for Spock's Beer. The part which ended up with in Spock's, for the Spock's Beard record, wasn't in the original demo I had sent to Kansas. I just kind of put together a whole bunch of different pieces, you know, for the Spock's Beard version. And then they took it and took out some of the original sections. Like, this original section was in the original version, but not in the Spock's Beard version. So they ended up just putting together a whole different version of it.
So we're listening to it, we realize that, you know, like Rio was saying, there's just too many slow songs, too much slow, moody stuff. We had a lot of moody stuff. So I was thumbing through this thing, and we got to this right here is like, we got right here, and it was like, oh, okay, hold on. What do we have here?
Getting to something. See our drum fiddle. Great.
When I heard that part, I just got this total rock vibe, and I just wanted to run to town with this aggressive, like, thing. Such a cool riff that you came up with on those parts, you know, those chords are really, really cool.
Basically, we took verse and chorus, and we extend intro.
Right.
Just like three times to become real intro and then guitar solo before the vocal. And the verse come in, chorus, second verse, double chorus.
Yeah.
Then we needed something there.
I love the way Jeff Lynne produces stuff, and he always has one little moment where things go crazy and you're just kind of like wakes you up and then it snaps you back into the song. So we kind of took this one part and just had everybody kind of go a bit crazy at this part. With no phase, then I went and I printed it onto this 24 track that's back over here, a 2-inch 24 track. And then I printed this down, which just sounds the same, but you use the VSO control to vary the tape speed, so as you're printing it down, you're slowing the tape down, up and down, back and forth.
Yeah.
And then when you put it together, I mean, it was, when I put it together and I laid it on back in and this phase happened like that, I was just like, oh man, this is cool. I mean, I'm in here like, maybe it seems like it cut.
It goes back.
Maybe it'll be.
And it goes back to like the chorus thing.
Exactly. Yep.
Okay.
So it ended up turning into this.